Welcome back, everybody. Some small new tidbits of information regarding the upcoming The Last Jedi. Nothing too earth-shattering, but let's take a look. First, we have a picture of the command bridge on Snoke's capital ship, the Supremacy. The main command bridge sits atop a massive structure located at the center of the Supremacy. The command bridge allows for 360-degree views, allowing for lookouts to see everything over the city-like structures that line the wing of this colossal ship. Now, here's another picture of what this structure is supposedly going to look like. Unfortunately, it's not exactly of the best quality, but here it is. It's a tower-like structure which would allow for the 360-degree view ability that was mentioned, although some have pointed out this might actually be a tower from Canto Bight and not the Supremacy itself. But if it is located on the Supremacy, haven't the bad guys learned anything? That's a tasty target for the Resistance to try and take out. It's basically how the Executor was destroyed in Return of the Jedi. Sure, it's probably well protected and all that, but it didn't stop the two Death Stars or Starkiller base from being taken out of commission. Back to this picture, here we can see that elevator over there. That's obviously the same elevator from the trailer where Kylo Ren has one of his temper tantrums. If the command bridge is indeed located on that tower that was mentioned, then we can assume Snoke's throne room is tucked away somewhere much more safer, maybe in the belly of the beast itself with escape pods prepared just in case. Speaking of Snoke's throne room, we have these cool looking collectible figures of Kylo and Rey, with Snoke's throne looming in the background. Now, the aspect ratio between the toys and the throne might not be exactly accurate, but let's assume it is. And if it is, that would kind of give us a sense of how tall Snoke is. He's supposed to be around 7 to 8 feet tall, but in the trailer, we didn't really get any scenes with him standing next to any other character. Even though in other toys, he's clearly portrayed as being much taller than those around him. I'm still not sure why these villains don't have a cushion or something to soften their backsides. Imagine sitting hours on end on something like that. No wonder he's so cranky. So there you have it, peoples. A little bit of info about the command bridge on the Supremacy. How are you liking the retro look? Does the inside aesthetic match the outside? Hopefully we get a better and more detailed pic of Snoke's capital ship soon. And do you think this is the target the Resistance will be setting their sights on? Or does Finn manage to sabotage the ship from within? Leave your thoughts down below. To stay updated with the channel, hit that notification bell. Thanks for dropping by and for the support. Don't forget to like, share, sub, and all that good stuff. And until next time, see yas.